So what's up everyone, and welcome to this, how do you call this, driving vlog, car vlog, I don't know, is there even such thing? So again, welcome guys to the video, and today, well, I'm just gonna be rambling for this video, cause basing from the title, I think you already know what I'm gonna be talking about. If you want to see what the title is all about, you can skip to this timestamp. But if you want to follow me all throughout the video, well, thank you, and go ahead and watch. So yeah, today I'm just gonna have some errands. I've got some errands to do for this whole afternoon. By the way, today is Tuesday and it is 1:10 p.m. I just finished training and took a shower, and now I'm heading heading to do my errands. So this is weird. I'll be talking to you later. See you guys later. So I set up the camera a little bit more, how do you call this, non-slidey. Anyway, like I said, I am going to do some errands today. I'm gonna have my personal computer fixed up, because that thing blew last weekend. I don't know what happened. I just, the moment I turned it on, few seconds later, and my power supply, I think, blew up. So anyway, yeah, that's one thing I have to do today. And then go to my mom's clinic, and then buy some drinking water, and then grab my mom's clothes from my uncle's house, and then pick up my mom, then go home. So this afternoon is gonna be hectic. I don't know if it's gonna be hectic, but I think it will. So I'm currently here on a paved parking lot in front of my mom's clinic. The line is so long. There you go. Oh my gosh. So my tires were skidding. Anyway, we are here at a pay parking lot in front of my mom's clinic, and there are no vacancies as of now, and I'm still waiting for vacant space. So yeah, anyway, I can finally see you guys. Yo, so I finally found one, and there you go. Oh yes, perfect fit. All right. So we are finally parked. I can finally look at you guys. Hello, hi. Anyway, I'm here at the parking lot again in front of my mom's clinic, and I'm gonna meet her and get some stuff, and after that I'll be coming back and grab some stuff. So see you later. Who am I kidding? The things you do for a vlog, I won't be leaving this. So I'll be going back in a short while, so see you later. So I'm back, and I just came from computer repair something shop, and the technician there said that I have to go to a different shop. So yeah, I'm going to a different shop right now and bring this bad boy behind. Can you see it? No, there, over there. So I'll bring this bad boy over there and see if they could fix my computer up. So yep. Is that you? Oh, it's gotta be. Thank you. Alright, so on to the main topic of this video. So again, just like I said, basing from the title.
Yep, I hurt myself. So last Monday, I was doing squats, and as I was doing squats, my belt was too tight, I think. And as I continued squatted, I don't know, there was some kind of discomfort in my, how do you call this, left rib or on my left side. Although I tried to ignore it at first because, you know, it was not that painful initially. But then as my sets went on, I really, really felt that kind of, how do you say it, suffocating pain. As I was doing my squats, I could not breathe on a certain position that I'm on. So as I squat down, yeah, it feels like my ribs are squeezing my lungs. I got worried so much. So I still tried to train around that kind of pain. I think it's not, you can't categorize it as an injury because there's no external factor that affected. Although there is, I think, my belt, but there were no torn muscle tissues involved, broken bones involved. So as per Kuya JC and as per the study, which I'm gonna link down in the description below. So it's just your body's way of trying to avoid a certain movement, and so that part becomes sensitive, thus signaling your brain to signal that part, your brain signaling that part of the body to be painful. Yeah, at first I really panicked, and I think that's how the brain works, because it sends a signal that, like I said, you should not do this activity, you should not do this movement. And then, yeah, that's what happened. So I don't know how to explain it any much further. Bottom line is, there was a time and a certain position that I couldn't breathe as I went to work. Again, my mind tried to escalate things up, but then I said, I know my body and I know what to do. As I went home, I tried to calm myself down and then tried thinking more logically what could have happened and what could have been the cause. So as I went home and lied down, I pondered upon it, and at the same time, Kuya JC sent me this article from Barbell Medicine. Barbell Medicine is usually our source when it comes to these kinds of topic. But anyway, yeah, there, that's what happened. So currently, I still have the pain on my left side. It's still lingering on, and I'm training my way around it, because, you know, like they said, don't avoid it and try to embrace it. So yeah, so today I did beltless squats, so I'm gonna be showing you the clip later. I'm gonna be showing you the clip right now. So I did beltless squats and I tried to train I tried to train around the pain. And I even tried putting on my belt again and see how the stimulus would be. But then it's really painful as I go down. So that's what happened this week. And if you think you're having some kind of pain or an injury or whatever, this is my personal or our opinion. If you want to seek professional help, go ahead and do so. We're not stopping you from that. It's just, you just have to know your body, know what works for you, and know how to train around it. And yeah, that's basically it. I hurt myself and I'm training around the pain. And there's one thing, one more thing that I wanna say. The more that you baby your injury, the more that you won't be able to overcome it. I know you know some people that get injured, then once everything is good, after a 2 week rest or a 1 week rest, they come back and then they get injured again. So they stop going to the gym or stop working out, and then they get injured again. So it's a yo-yo, it's a back and forth thing. That's basically it. So there you have it. I hurt myself. and try not to hurt yourselves as well. And if you're still with me, I'm trying to make a U-turn out here because the computer repair shop is on the other side of the lane, so I have to make a U-turn. So there you have it. So finally, a movement happened. So it's already 3:58, almost 4. It's basically 4 p.m. and it's starting to get dark because it's raining. And I just finished one errand for the day. I'm on my way to do the rest. So yeah, this is basically how my day went. You know, life outside training. All right, so on to my next errand, drinking water. I'll see you later. Again, the things you do for vlogs. Second errand done. Oh my gosh, it's already 4:18. I have one more errand, two more. One is to get my mom's clothes, and the last errand is to pick her up and go home. So I'll do one more errand and call it a day. So if you guys are still with me in this video, watching me do my errands, thank you so much. You deserve all the love. Watching a man doing his errands. I hope you guys are entertained though. Again, stay safe, be healthy, lift heavy, and eat a lot, enjoy life. That's basically how we should live, am I right? Oh, it's the bumpy road. Oh, there you go. So I'll pick up my mom's clothes, and I'll be back. Again, the things you do for the vlog. Okay, so I am finally done with my second to the last errand, and my last errand would be to pick up my mom from work. So there you have it. That is it for me today. Thank you guys so much for watching, and if you stayed again with me all throughout this video, thank you so much for watching all throughout. Finger heart. This is so awkward. I'm doing finger hearts in front of a camera while driving. Anyway, that's it for me today. See you guys on the next video. Bye. So I have to move over to stop this camera. Bye.